Let's go to the moment that you pulled the trigger and killed your father. Did you intend to kill him then?
No. I had no intention of taking his life. I wanted him to know that when I said, we're leaving and this is going to stop, that I meant it. And I wanted to be a threat, but I didn't mean to harm him.
You go back to the house. He is semi-conscious on the couch. He's been drinking, as he usually was. What happens then?
The gun was downstairs, and I think I just went back to that moment where I saw him dragging my sister into his bedroom, and I just stepped over a line that no one should have to step over.
And you shot him?
And I shot him.
The first shot doesn't kill him. He does what? How does he react?
He didn't realize that he had been shot, and he woke up screaming my name, sat up sitting my name, saying my name. And so, you know, I was terrified and immediately remorseful for what had happened. And I went and turned on the porch light and opened the door and was going to find a phone to call an ambulance. And then he just started calling me and Christy all kinds of names and blamed us for the ambulance taking too long to come. Earlier during the altercation that had happened, he took all the phones and ripped them out of the wall and had hit them. So when I went to go find a phone to save his life, I couldn't find it. And he started calling me all kinds of whores and bitches and told me to just wait until he got up from that couch. And I knew that if he ever got up, that we would die.
So what did you do?
I shot him a second time.
In the head this time?
I didn't know where it was. I had placed the gun on a ledge behind him and just closed my eyes and pulled the trigger. And I just figured whatever happened would happen.